Hello learners, this is Bharti Satish. Today we are going to know about Elegy written in the country churchyard, written by Thomas Gray. He belongs to 1716 to 1771. He is a self-critical writer, an English poet and a classical scholar too. He started his career as a classicist and ended with a romanticist. Right. He studied in Eton College and his friends were Horace Walpole, Richard West and Thomas Austin. And he belongs to the graveyard poets, because there were few other members in the graveyard poets. They were William Cowper, Christopher Smart, Oliver Goldsmith, Thomas Parnell, Robert Blair and Edward Young. Please do make note of this, guys. It has been asked in many TRB and as well as in NET questions that what kind of poets they were all. They will give you 4 or 5 members and they will ask you to choose any 5 of them, right? And he worked as a professor of history and modern language at Cambridge in 1768. And another important thing about is he has been awarded poet laureateship, but he in 1757, but he rejected it. Okay. Then we'll move on to his specific works, where Ode on Spring, Sonnet on the Death of Mr. Richard West, Hymn to Adversity, Ode on the Distant Prophet of Elton. And we move on to the poetry, Elegy written in the country churchyard. It is a graveyard poetry too, and it has been written in 1750 and published in 1751 in February in magazine by Robert Dodsley. It has been composed of 32 stanzas, in which 29 stanzas were the poetry lines and the last 3 stanzas serve as an epitaph, and each stanza composed of 4 lines each. And the rhyming scheme in this poetry is, it has been written in heroic quatrain with the iambic pentameter, and this poetry is partly inspired by the death of a poet, Richard West, who died in 1742. Now we know about the poem little more, and it is about this entire poem is all about the unknown humble villagers, or the villages were the farmers, and how they were lived, and after that what is the condition of their coffin were mentioned by in this poetry, and the time poet mentioned in this poetry is twilight. Twilight means that is the evening time, that the sun is sun setting and the night reaching that time, that evening time. And the place where poet expresses his expressed in this poetry is St. Giles Churchyard of Stockpokes, which is the place where Thomas Gray's mother was buried, and he himself was buried in the same place after his death, right? And a few of the poetry passages were translated into Latin by P.B. Shelley. This is an important point. And in this poetry, poet mentions about the 2 trees, and under their shadows, the coffins of the villages were with the dead villages were buried, and the trees were the yew tree or the elm tree. And in the starting of the poetry, he says that an owl complained to the moon about how her residence were disturbed by the winds and all those things in the introductory part. And he says that the unseen heroes buried in the churchyard are similar like the pure gems hidden in the ocean. And he says that the Hampton, who is a courtier who against the unjust tax leveled by Charles I, and he has been mentioned here for resembling power, and Oliver Cromwell, who is a great leader, and he has been referred for the glory, and John Milton, who is a great poet, died without attaining any fame, he has been mentioned for the fame. It has been asked in the previous year questions that who are the 3 mentioned for the power, glory and fame. They were Hampton, Cromwell and Milton. Power, glory and fame, Hampton, Cromwell and Milton. Right. And in the stanza 9, very very important line came there. We all know that Far From Mary Crown is a novel written by Thomas Hardy, and that title has been taken from this poem, and that line occurs in the 19th stanza of this poetry. Right. In this entire poem, Gray talked about the dead village persons. They were not very familiar, and he says that the old people die says something, after their death. Maybe they were telling that the poet lying under the peach tree, or look at the brook running in the nostril. And one day the old man not seen the poet anywhere, and in the third day the poet found in a coffin with the epitaph on the grave under old hawthorn tree. Right, in the epitaph, young man, no fame with no fortune, and of his humble birth, he learned science also, and he says himself in the form of young man, and he says that young man wants all the things for his friends, not for himself. So he has been blessed with God's mercy, and he has been lie in the lap of God and in the heaven, and he reached with God for eternal life. With this note, the poetry ends. This is a tremendously beautiful poetry written by Thomas Gray, and hope you like this, and we will meet you in the next video.